Most people who buy estate cars buy medium-sized ones. And in fact, medium estate cars now account for some 6.5% of all new cars sold. The latest contender in the medium estate field from British Leyland, the Austin Allegro Estate. Now, this is very much a three-door car rather than a converted van with windows. Leyland's researchers indicate it's likely to go to the private owner rather than the fleet operator, and they hope it'll win back the sort of customer who used to buy the old 1300 Countryman, discontinued about a year ago. Unlike some estate cars, the rear seat comfort is ample, as indeed is the headroom. Now, with that rear seat in place, there's 10.25 cubic feet of load-carrying capacity without getting in the way of your rear view. Turning into a full estate is simplicity itself. You merely lift the squab here and then, using the central release lever, one, down she goes. Now, in this condition, you've got 53 cubic feet of load-carrying capacity. Now, both those statistics are almost identical to Ford's Escort estate. But here's the big difference. Remember, the Allegro is front-wheel drive, which means that there aren't any rear-wheel drive components that can intrude into this low, flat, and very useful luggage-carrying area. The usable distance between the wheel arches is 43 inches, which makes the Allegro at least the match of its competitors in this group. It's certainly extremely high at the back. This is to accommodate the rear door's opening mechanism, which being up in the roof at least doesn't interfere with the loading aperture at all. The rear side windows don't open, always a shame we reckon, but there is through-flow fresh air ventilation. But practical or no, one has to say the appearance is slightly odd, if not ungainly at the back, certainly an acquired taste. Part of the very comprehensive standard package, screen wiper and washer for the back window, which on a flat back estate like this always attracts lots of road dirt. Under here, either the old familiar A-Series 1300 overhead valve unit or the Max's overhead camshaft 1500, both thoroughly proven for some years. The best features, superb underbonnet accessibility for all the serviceable items, everything from the wiper motor to the starter solenoid. Full marks for such attention to detail as the way the wiring loom is secured to the body shell, with all the clip tabs carefully sheathed to prevent chafing over the years. Like the Allegro saloon, the estate has the same front-to-back connected but fully independent hydrogas suspension system, which gives it a characteristically bouncy ride. In fact, in a crosswind, and with this body shape, I found it rather choppy, but totally absorbent nonetheless. Also included in the price, about £20 worth of full inertia reel seat belts. The original Allegro quartic steering wheel, that was that squarish shaped thing, has gone and been replaced by a much more convenient round one. Fingertip controls here, really at your fingertips, very well positioned indeed. And I particularly liked up here, lots of spaces for those odd oddments that seem to accumulate. The most vital statistics, petrol consumption, well, between 32 and 50 to the gallon is possible on the 1300 engine, between 28 and the 45 mark for the 1500cc. Price from £1,880, that's for the 1300, £100 more for the 1500. Both are still cheaper than the smallest Maxi, and Leyland forecast that they'll be selling twice as many 1300s as 1500s. In conclusion then, our view is that the Allegro estate is, as standard, probably about the best equipped and best value for money in the medium estate car field at the moment.